Hello guys, in electrical control systems, the most frequently used elements are capacitor, resistor and inductor. These are the basic elements, and we usually perform modeling of other elements in terms of these three basic elements, like transmission lines. For the analysis of transmission lines, these three basic elements are normally used. Similarly, for other control systems, important control systems, these elements are mostly used. So understanding these elements in detail is very important. So first of all, here we have a capacitor. Capacitor and inductor are energy storage elements, whereas resistor is a passive element, which is a energy dissipation device. Both all are passive devices, but capacitor and inductor are energy storage devices. So voltage current relationship, here we have V of t is equal to 1 over C integration of I of t into dt, or I of t is equal to C into dv by dt. So this is the current through the capacitor, which is possible when there is a change in the voltage. If the voltage is constant like a DC current, then the capacitor will not conduct and current will be equal to zero. Also, we have the famous formula Q is equal to CV, or V is equal to 1 over C into Q. And now its impedance in Laplace transform, we have its impedance 1 over C into S, and admittance is the inverse of the impedance, it is equal to C into S. For resistor, we have V is equal to IR, Ohm's law, or I is equal to V over R, and for V is equal to R into dq by dt, since current is equal to the equal to dq by dt, and its impedance is R, and its admittance would be 1 over R. And for inductor, we have the formula voltage is equal to L into di by dt, that is the voltage is induced due to the change of current in the inductor, and current is equal to 1 over L integration of voltage, or V is equal to L into d square q over dt square, and its impedance will be equal to L into S, and admittance will be equal to 1 over LS. So these relationships are very important to understand and remember while solving our circuits.